Welcome to AG MOOCs courses on GIS in Agriculture, Essentials and Applications. Now, we will be going to the next aspects how GIS could be used in the village and land information system, which is of rural importance. And here there are lot many things which we may have to do before we get on to the different mode. Now, what is the land information system, either in the rural or in the urban? We need effective sustainable land planning is missing. We need to have the progressive development and maintenance is the need of the hour. The unplanned activities need to be curtailed so that our environmental as well as resources can be managed and the services can be provided. Also is the to meet the growing land real estate markets, its development and economic activity in general for the growth of the country. What is happening is the existing historical record keeping efforts are expensive and not safe. What I wanted to say is what we have is many of them are most of them are in the form of a papers. Maintaining this paper based documents in the offices of a multiple way activities are going on, it is very difficult to do that, and the decaying of this paper products also that take place. We are not able to locate these records in time, so that some of the activities are getting delayed. One among the delays include by this type of location of data sets or records from the record office. Now, we should know what are we doing it now. This is what the need is. What are we doing now? See, we are having village maps. Village maps, this is one among the village map. This village map contains land parcels and also road sections and also then your river as well as other activities. The Gauntan is the settlements. This is how the taluk plans which are available with the existing villages in a taluk place. Now, what is the scale of this is? The scale is almost 1:5,000. Now, another one that is a tassel type. Now, the another one is about the village maps. The village maps, you have the land parcel here, there, as well as we have some amount of settlements. This is the type of maps which are being used in the Maharashtra state. Another map record which are being used in the Orissa is, it is a digitized one. They have got the land parcels, maybe a road network on either side of it or maybe a river, and all other activities, important activities are done in a local language. Now, these Satbara records, they have got an attribute data, that is what we call it as a record of rights. This is what people call it as a property card. Now, the property card is an important aspect. What does it do about the property cards? The property card is tells you about what is your area which you own it and where it is located and adjoining activities. If it is the first time, your name will be there. If you have bought it from somebody else, his name will be there as the thing. Now, when you are going for a search, whether it has been or the other man is the man who is selling is the correct person, the searching is needed. The searching of this type of property cards takes a lot of time and it delays our efforts. This is one. Another property cards of the Satbaras, which are the agriculture land, that is go over here. It gives same thing about the name of the farmer, how much is the acreages, what are all the different crops he grows during the Kharif. Kharif is nothing but a rainy days, that is from July to November, and winter crops October to, you have it up to December or January, then summer crops you start from January, February up to April. So this is the crop areas, Satbaras, that is what we call it in Maharashtra state, and which is nothing but a agriculture plot identification number. Now this crop area, this is the plot area wise, then the what type of crop he grows it, whether he changes from one crop to another crop. So that information which is collected just for a tax purpose and other activities. Now what is happening is some of our rural areas, they are being converted into urban areas. Now what we need is some places, we all might have heard the very big thing in the news that this many acres of land has been grabbed from the rural people, and this much of areas have been converted from agriculture land to the urban areas. So these type of things, whether it is urban, whether it is usable, not usable, whether they are using it or not using it, those type of information is needed, one thing. Second thing is, over a period of time, how many times it has taken like that, or how much area has been converted, agriculture land area has been converted into urban sprawl. Suppose if you have lost so much of agriculture land, what happens to your productivity? What was the production at that point of time which we have lost forever? So these are all the questions which happens when we want to increase the crop production by 70% of the existing crop production during 2050 for the future population growth. So this information, accurate information, at a one point information, so that we will be able to get it immediately, and our decision making process in all developmental activities could be secure. Now the first application why we need a accurate data is urban sprawl analysis, conversion of the previous land use like agriculture, non-agriculture, used, non-used, and how it has been converted into the things. Then second thing is, if what we need is, we need some greeneries in the urban areas, so that there is a temperature decrease is always possible, fresh air could be used. For that what we need is, we need some amount of land cover, so that land cover takes care of the heat. So land use, land cover mapping, how the land cover was there before and how the land cover, that means how many trees have gone off, how much area of greenery has been there. That is another analysis which we are doing it effectively to meet the climate change aspects. Now is landform, land reforms analysis. Then when it comes down to the land reform analysis in the form of a policy, so that is the first thing which they would like to do that. Now what is happening is, geodetic surveys are being done using the total stations to append the information which was not available in the earlier thing. So now what you do is, take the basic maps which are available, do some represent analysis, do some surveys here and there, and then append it, so that the data would be much more accurate. Now major thing which we are hearing is, or in the climate changes, there is going to be a high intensity rainfall, there is going to be high amount of flood, there are going to be other related activities also that leads to natural disaster. Now in the high intensity rainfall in the recent areas, there were a lot of flooding has happened. Even the flood water have standing up to the 6 feet 7 feet. So that means the area where that settlement has come up, it was not suitable for the land use purpose. So to avoid such natural disasters, it may not happen immediately, if it happens, whatever the investment which you have made, those things will go off. In to support this, there is a good land record management aspect which is missing, which could be improved on due to so many reasons. Then if I have to do it, the British way is land and property assessment and tax collection for our finance. Almost people are talking about smart city planning. The smart city, what people are planning is, where everything is available and without any much of degradation to the existing environment. These are all the needs, immediate needs for an accurate land information system for management.